68 members are there.
You can start the second link also.
Okay,
you can
ma'am.
Share both.
Yes, ma'am. Shall I start? Suresh, sir, shall I start?
Anita, ma'am, you can start, ma'am. You can start.
Okay, ma'am. Good afternoon to one and all. Time is free, but it's priceless. You can't own it, but you can use it. You can't keep it, but you can spend it. Once you have lost, you can never get it back. On behalf of SKCET, I'm Anita, Assistant Professor, Computer Science and Engineering from Shri Krishna College of Engineering and Technology, welcoming you all for the Session 8 AICTE ATEL sponsored online faculty development program on intelligent computing in data science. As a part of Fit India, this is a special session arranged on time management. To deliver the session on time management, I feel very honored to welcome our chief guest of the day, Dr. M. Kalyanasundaram, Dean, Tamil Nadu Agricultural University, Coimbatore. Dr. M. Kalyanasundaram began his career in Tamil Nadu Agricultural University as assistant professor during the year 1986 and became 18th Dean of Agriculture College and Research Institute in the year 2019. Dr. M. Kalyanasundaram, as an undergraduate teacher for more than 34 years and a postgraduate teacher for the last 20 years, did the best of his ability for the students' community. His own academic excellence with his attitude for teaching has motivated many students to become young faculties in Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, Agriculture Research Services, as well as National Laboratories, responsible officers in several organizations. He was one among the faculty member responsible for the achievements of securing 80 ICAR Junior Merit Fellowship from Tamil Nadu Agriculture University. And also, 7 students secured national first rank also. Students awarded with highest scores in students' feedback evaluation for his teaching. He was judged as a best teacher and received best teacher award from Tamil Nadu Agriculture University in the year 2004. He was also conferred with Lifetime Achievement Award in March 2020 by Entomological Society of India, New Delhi. He has published 27 research papers in international journals, 41 research papers in national journals, and also 23 other popular articles in various National Academy of Agricultural Science rated journals. He has also written 7 textbooks and 15 practical manuals in agricultural entomology to enrich UG undergraduate and postgraduate teaching. He received a Best Book Award for the year 2008 for the book Biological Control for Sustainable Agriculture by Tamil Nadu Government and received Best Writer Award from Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. He served as Member University Board of Studies for 3 years to revamp the syllabus. He served as Farm Manager for 3 years at Horticultural Research Station, Tadiyan Kudizai from 86 to 89 and improved the station without availing a single day of leave. Two of his research findings were included in Crop Production Manual released by the Department of Agricultural and University jointly. He was instrumental to set up 4 Commerce Biocontrol Laboratories set up by unemployed postgraduate of Tamil Nadu Agriculture University. Involved himself for large-scale field demonstration, carried out 8 major crops covering 10 districts of Tamil Nadu at an area of 1,065.8 hectare to prove the efficacy of biocontrol agents on former holdings. In the year of 2012, he received recognition certificate from Vice-Chancellor of Tamil Nadu Agriculture University for his outstanding contribution in papaya mealybug control through large-scale release of parasitoid, which results in massive reduction on pesticide usage on crops. And also, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome all the professors from various colleges for this wonderful session. An inch of time is an inch of gold. but you can't buy it. That inch of time with inch of goal. This, with this note, I'd like to hand over the session to Dr. Kalyanasundaram, sir. Over to sir.
Dr. J. Janet, Professor A. Priya, Professor S. Suresh Kumar, Department of Computer Science, Sri Krishna College of Engineering and Technology, faculty members, scholars, and my dear student friends and other participants of today's program. I feel really honored to present the topic on time management with the scholarly group, for which I am highly indebted for the organizers for giving me this opportunity to share some views about time management. So without wasting a single minute of time, let me straight away go to the presentation in proper. Is it audible? Shall I continue?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Audible, sir.
Okay. So the very important results.
Ma'am, orenum show.
The very important resource on this earth is time. So everybody doesn't care about it, and without our knowledge, you can stop any resource, but not time.
Sir, so sir, kindly wait for a minute. Ma'am, in second link, I have muted the...
No, you have to unmute and attend presentation. Attend FTP presentation.
Ma'am, can you hear now?
Yes, ma'am, but kindly unmute the attend FTP presentation audio.
Ma'am, I have unmuted it.
No, presentation audio.
Ma'am, once again, ma'am.
Check in the people list.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, it's not unmute. I cannot able to unmute it, ma'am.
Ma'am, now voice is audible, ma'am.
Sir, now?
Yes, sir, yes, now? Now audible. Second link also audible.
Yes, sir.
You mute the first link, ma'am, here. Yes, okay. Sir, carry on, sir.
Thank you. So for the personality development, some, when we ask what do you mean by personality, some used to tell that tallness, whitish color, richness, higher educational qualification, and the position, power. So these are all not really the permanent personality. To improve in our life, the very important personality is the internal personality. For the internal personality, there are a certain very important criteria are there. One among the most important criteria, which I consider, is the managing the time. Next. So let me start with a very important quote given by our saint Thiruvalluvar in Tamil. Nyalam karudinum kaikudum, kalam karudi idathal seyin. It means, nyalam, the world will come to your hand when you do the work timely, giving importance for time. If you started respecting time, time will respect you and time will take you to a greater heights. So that way, time is most important. 2500 years ago, the saint has also mentioned a separate couplet for importance of the time management. Next. So in your hand, daily, God is giving a very important resource. This particular resource alone is uniform and equal to all the individuals throughout the world. It is time management. We must be careful in managing this most important resource. The reason is, it is a raw material. Using iron, you can make a bureau. Using cotton, you can make a cloth. Like that, if you wanted to develop in your life, the most important resource on your hand is time. That you always keep it in your mind. Next. So this is one of the very important research by Asker Barrett from United States of India, who studied the usage of Indians. How do they waste different important resources? Indians, they waste cosmetics 10%. For example, soap or oil or scent or anything. The last bottommost portion, we never use it. That can be merged with another new soap and that can be used, but we will throw it away. Most of the powder tins, the last portion, we never use. Similarly, any marriage or any function you go and watch, most of our people, they waste 20% of the food items. So they never care for the hard work of our farmers. They never respect the sweat of our farmers. They waste it, thinking that they have money, they have every right, book and question. That way, they will waste. Similarly, in any office, in any building you go, people will be away, but the fans will be switched on. Water resources, electricity, natural resources. Indians, they waste 30%. In any house, during whitewash or house cleaning, you will find a lot of medicines. All half used or 25% used. A syrup or a cough syrup or an important medicine. All will be heaped on one place and people should have used it for somebody else. They should have given to somebody else. They should have deposited to the needy persons. But they waste it around 40%. So Indians are very important people. They doesn't care about the important waste. This is one side. But next, remember, Indians, in general, they waste 60% of their time. A very important resource. The first four resources that can be brought back, but this is gone. So very, very carefully, we have to use it. Next. Every day, God is giving us 86,400 golden coins. Number of students' classes, I used to ask students, have you received this resource? Students used to tell, sir, I don't have even 10 paisa in my pocket. How you are telling 86,400 golden coins? The golden coins are 24 into 60 minutes into 60 seconds if you multiply. But this resource is something unique. This is the only resource which is equal to Andipatti Angamuthu to Abdul Kalam or America to India, or to Tamil Nadu, to Gujarat, anywhere, any place, for all the human beings, this is the only resource which is equal to everybody. And another important thing, this one resource, something is unique. What way unique means, you cannot deposit this particular amount in a State Bank of India or any bank. You cannot stop it. You cannot transfer it. And whether you are using it or not, the resource will diminish. And you cannot blame anybody else. You are responsible. So one should be very careful. Daily morning, remember, God is giving 86,400 golden coins to you. You have to utilize it very, very carefully. So how much time you have to go for sleep? How much time you can spend for bath? How much time for studies? What is very, very important? You have to spend it very carefully. Remember, in the time, these 86,400 seconds, you can invest, you can spend, you can waste. It is all in your hands. You are the doctor and you are the patient. Please remember. So hereafter, please be very, very carefully. This is the resource. Some of the students, they used to go to home. during Saturdays and Sundays. And Monday when they return, I used to ask them, oh, how much money you have wasted. The students used to tell, sir, I have not wasted any money. No. You went to your home. You should have stayed in the hostel. Now, around 1,62,000 golden coins you have wasted. So that way, please remember, hereafter, even 1 hour is wasted. That is a very, very important resource. Keep it always in your mind. Next. So to realize this value, whatever I say, you will not get it. For example, a person who is training for so many years, if his last is in the Olympics, he knows the value of 4 years. In the office, somebody miss the promotion. Next year only he will get the promotion. It means he will shout, he will be angry, he will scold the system. So he knows the value of 1 year. You ask the value of 10 months, a mother, due to some health problem, if she lost the child during pregnancy, she knows the value of 10 months. You ask the value of 1 month, a person who received his salary, if his last means he cannot pay anything to his house rent, then for cable, for milk, for newspaper, household expenditure, he will cry, he will weep. He knows the value of a month. Similarly, you ask the value of 1 week. A person, an editor who is running a weekly magazine, because Sunday means the magazine has to be released. So who knows the value of a week? Suppose today is a month. You ask a auto wala, a coolie, yes, a person, a daily wage labor, who knows the value of 1 day. He cannot earn anything. So similarly, 1 hour, a person who met with an accident, if you take him to the hospital, doctor used to say, no, you missed the golden hour. Just if you had brought him 1 hour before, his life should have been saved. So 1 hour, the value is known. An accident, the victim. So a person who is waiting in a garden or in a bus stand for his lover, who knows the value of 10 minutes. If the lover is late by 10 minutes, this person will think that it is some years have gone. That way, he knows the value of 10 minutes. Similarly, you ask the person who missed the train, just 1 minute. You are in a railway station, people will tell, no, just now Nilgiris has left. So I was there due to traffic, I missed the train. Oh, people used to shout, cry, weep, scream. So who knows the value of 1 minute? Similarly, value of 1 second, the while you are watching the cricket match, somebody missed the ball, very important player. So who knows the value of 1 second? P.T. Visha, the golden coin, golden award, just because of 1 millisecond time. So imagine, for everything, there is a time. There is a time limit. People understand, whoever comes on these channels, they will be knowing the value of time. Please realize, time is such a very, very important value. Please realize it. Next. So every second counts. You cannot buy 1 inch of time by giving 1 inch of gold. Can you get back the morning hour of today, 9/12/2020, afternoon 1 o'clock, in your life again? No, you won't get it. Every second it counts. That is why in the clock we give a sound called as tick, tick, tick. So if you fail to use this day's deposit, the loss is yours. Next. So there is a smart analysis. Any management students, they will be recent days. Most of the management training, we used to tell SMART. Please be smart. Smart analysis. Specific, meaningful, action-oriented, realistic. But all this SMAR will be successful, provided it is done in a correct, timely. So timely work, timely get up, timely discharge of our duties, timely living of the responsibilities. Please be timely. Suppose you are not timely, all other talents will turn to zero. Note that. Next. So most of the people, will not be knowing where does our time goes. Suppose a person who lives for 72 years, a research finding says that 25 years he spends in sleep. Next, 4 years he spends his time for eating. 6 years he spends for watching television and other items. 2 years he spends for searching the last items. So many houses people used to search, where is my specs, where is my mobile phone, where is my scale, where is my pen, where is my key. So during 72 years, 2 years we search the last items. 8 years only we spend a time for studies. Suppose a person is not a graduate, the time is will still be less. Next, another 5 years we are all wasting our time for communication, mobile phone usage, telephone. Probably in the year 2000 and all, it will be still more higher. 5 years. Next, recreation in the name of joy, in the name of tour, in the name of going to a job, travel. So all those things we spend 7 years of time. Next, and 3 years of time daily our travel from one place to another through a two-wheeler or a car to a job or a school. So 3 years goes in day-to-day affairs of travel. Next, remember 12 years only during 72 years we work. So if he's a graduate, if he's willing to work, if he's dedicated, only 12 years. And if the same analysis is carried out in a Japanese country, it is double. It is double. How? So they reduce the sleep. They reduce so much of recreations. They reduce too much of travel. They reduce the communication devices. And they concentrate on work. So take care of these very important aspects and plan accordingly. Do not waste your time. That is the message. Next. So there is a warning. Please take that. Most of the times, 50% of our time goes where? It is sleeping, personal grooming, eating and commuting. So if you just reduce these four outer squares, definitely the inner area will be further strengthened and you can be a better person, provided if you concentrate on these four important areas. Be careful. Next. So in the London tower clock, those who have visited London, the top of the tower clock London, they used to write a very important quote called as "Time flies, mind your business. Time and tide waits for none." You cannot stop your time. Though you may be too much of a powerful person on the earth, you cannot order. You can order to anybody, but you cannot order the clock to stop. So it is a very, very important resource. London Tower Clock, Big Ben, this word was written. Why I am telling is, if you go to Japanese or London roads, if you ask a person, "Sir, where to go, this address, where it is located?" Nobody will respond. They will tell a word, go to the traffic person and ask, "Do not waste my time." Because the time flies. You are stopping my work. There are persons for that work. You go and ask them. In our country, if you go and ask in a road, "Sir, this is the place I wanted to go," they will call you, they will chat you, they will discuss you, they will spend more of time. They will tell which place you are going, which person you are going to meet, and they will tell the history of the person to whom you are going to meet. So that way, people, they spend a lot of time. In number of business forums, somebody was asked, "Why you are not starting any work? Why you are idle?" Persons in Tamil Nadu, sometimes they used to tell, "This is Yada Nata Chani." It means 7.5 years, his astrology is bad, he won't do any work. Okay, why you are not doing any work during this month? "This is Adi month, unauspicious month, so I am not going to do anything." Okay, today, why you are not started this work? "Today is Tuesday, it is not a good day." Okay,
background.
Today, why you are not come in time? Why you are not started this work? No, no, this is Ragu Kalam, bad time. So people, without understanding all those important aspects, they tell some reasons and others, and they spend time. You can watch in Saraswati Puja, people hide all the textbooks and keep a Saraswati photo over it and tell that Saraswati Puja no one should study. Saraswati is studying. In the picture, Saraswati is opening a book and reading. But these fellows, they are all telling that don't read because this is the day. So like that, most of us, we have a reason. We have a genuinity. We create something in our mind and we reason it. So don't do it. Remember, time flies. Next. So time wasted is the existence. Time used is life. Do you want to exist or live? You decide. Edward Young, a great professor from US, used to tell that most of the people are existing. They are not living. Living person means he has to use his time effectively. We all have time either to spend or to waste or to invest. It is all our decision. What to do it? But remember, but once it is passed, it is gone forever. Remember the same audience group, I used to ask a question. Can we all join now a primary school? Suppose we all go travel in a bus and ask the headmaster in a primary school, sir, we have missed all these things we wanted to read now. Will you admit? Will you permit? So remember, that resource is over. It is gone. Very, very carefully we must travel. That is the message. Next. So what way the time is wasted? In India, there are several things. I referred to so many articles. Major important points I found out. One of the thing is the modern gadget telephone. So remember, telephone is a very important instrument. Telephone is for communication. So telephone is important, but it is not for conversation. You have a message, you have to pass the message. Quickly you do it. So modern gadget, these cell phones, several persons, they spend a lot of time for good morning, good night. Is that sharing, but not caring. So lot of, in the name of friendship, red tapism. So unclear government, governmental systems, procedures. So unclear objectives. Procrastination, it means a postponement, laziness. Why you are not doing? Tomorrow I will do. Why you are not submitted the project? Next week I will submit. Why you are not done this? Oh, okay, sir, I went there. So I had a commitment. I went to my home. I went to meet somebody else. In the name of vehicle travel, every week, going here, there. So in the very closer to their house, there are a lot of shops. But he will travel to distant places for purchase and waste time. Inefficiency. So they never learn a computer. They never learn a typing. They never improve their skill. So inefficiency, it causes a lot of wastage of time. Boredom. That is not having any exercise, not having walking, something, alertness. So they never do it. So they will always sleepy, boredom. So every time in the office they come, they will tell, I am going for a tea. When they take the tea, I will refresh. Afternoon, morning, 1 hour. So too much of visitors. So number of in the college, in the university, we also feel. People will come. I will ask, what is the reason? No, Justin, I came here to meet you. What for? No, no, on the way I wanted to meet you. People who are filing facilities. So not properly, papers were not filed properly. References were not to be brought quickly. Fatigueness, tiredness, health. And inability to say no. Sir, sorry, sir, I cannot do this. So you can go somewhere else. I cannot accommodate this. There is a great book called Don't Say Yes When You Intend to Say No. So whenever you say no, do not waste my time here. No planning. What to do tomorrow? What is next? More of meetings. In India, these meetings, minutes are recorded, but hours are lost. Cinema, serial, TV, demotivating friends. So everything they will tell some reasons. Everything they will curse others. They will tell other unwanted materials. So like that, so many things. If you can list, these are all the time eaters. Take care of from today onwards. Try to throw it the unwanted items and give importance for your development. Next, remember always, we are all traveling at the rate of 60 minutes per hour. This cannot be increased. Whatever may be the great person, you cannot accelerate the velocity. You cannot increase the speed. It is all judged. So carefully, slowly thinking what to do, what next, plan it and do it. So 60 minutes per hour travel is life. Remember. Next. So what way? You may ask the question, sir, today 2 o'clock this session has started, it ends after 3:30. What the benefit I will get because of your lecture? There are certain benefits, definitely. So as a teacher for 34 years in the Agriculture University, I taught these lessons in most of the classes. Most of my students, they became IAS and IPS, IFS officers. They used to remember, still whenever I used to meet them, they used to tell, sir, it has helped in my life. The same way, it will help you to avoid the time traps. It will give freedom and control. It will help opportunities. It helps to avoid guilt. It helps to see the what is to be done. It will improve your studies. You will be a refreshed person. And all those things, if you wanted to develop in life, so give more importance for time management. So a lot of benefits are there. So infinite benefits are there. Please remember. Next. So please remember, some people used to tell that, oh, time has gone. Please remember, time will never be gone. Time is there. You are gone. Hereafter, don't tell that, oh, time is gone. No, time is there. Time goes, you say. No, alas, time stays, we go. Henry Austin Dobson, one of the very, very scholarly person, in his famous book on time management, this message, I derived it and I used to share it. Next. So there are a lot of myths. So during the end of the session, you will also sometime will tell, whatever you say, sir, my time is not in my hand. When my boss give a work, how can I say that I will not do it? It is not, my life is completely controlled by other person, sir. My wife says that this work you do it. Shall I tell to her I cannot do it? My in the place of my work, my colleagues, they are giving something else. So it is a myth what you are telling. Time is not in my hand. I have no limit. I don't have any control. So these are all something. Remember, these are all myths. These are all reasons you are telling. These reasons are not at all acceptable. Why I am telling is, at the end you will accept really what professor has said is only correct. What we all dream is myth. Next. Remember, you cannot possible to hold a day. Today, this Wednesday, you cannot hold, but it is possible not to lose it. Carefully we spend means you can use this resource definitely for the betterment. Better definitely for the development. Definitely for the development of you and your family, all your members. So time management is a very, very important resource. Next. Remember, always concentrate on results, not on being busy. Some used to tell, I am very busy, sir. Morning itself, I am very busy. Okay, you are busy. Today morning you have got up. Okay, have you did some exercise? No, sir, I wanted to do exercise. Somehow the paper has come. And I have concentrated. Rain has come. Then morning, I was about to do these things. I cooked the milk. I had a backache also. So they will never tell results. They will tell that reasons, how they were busy. So remember, the results are more important. How you are busy, we are not. Nobody is not important. Henry Thoreau's very, very important paper on concentrate on results, not on being busy. Just type in Google, you will get a 8-page beautiful article. Read it. Next. So there is a great person called as a Pareto. The Pareto's rule says that 80% of our time goes in 20% importance. Similarly, 20% of time we are giving 80% importance. It is reverse. What for you have to spend your time, we never spent. For your health, how much of time you have spent today morning? So just analyze in your mind, you work it out. In this same group, I ask, how many of you today did exercise? How many of you today had a walking? While you are walking, you will be planning. Remember, a person daily in the morning, when he walks, what will happen is automatically he will plan. Indirectly, he will plan while walking. Today, this is the work, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 3 o'clock, this way, that way. So your planning efficiency will go up. So these are all very important. You are not giving importance for your health. You are giving importance for a news channel. You are giving importance for a political magazine. So much chit-chatting, sharing the messages to others. All, is it useful to you? Useful to your career? One doctor used to tell, Kalyan Sundaram, daily open the newspaper and immediately go to the exercise quickly. Because open the newspaper and find whether in the obituary your photo is there or not. If it is not there, you go for walking. Don't spend your time on others' matters. These are less important in life. So in that way, so very, very important thing is any list of tasks, 80% you give importance for majority of the items. So that way your life will prosper. That is the rule of Pareto's principle. Next. So this is the success wheel. And the success wheel, most of the management group, they say the forks may be different. It may be money, quality, mission, or so much. But the central axis, the center or the core of the success is the time management. It all should be linked in the time. If the central core is missing, all the other forks will be damaged. So next, just put. You see the next press, see, when the success wheel moves where the central axis of time management takes you to greater heights. Next. So how to improve the time? You may ask a question now. So far I said this way, that way, time all goes there. How to manage this time? So plan ahead. You have a plan, some goals. So number of the youngsters, youth, you ask, what is your goal? They don't have any goals. What is your milestone? At the age of 45, how you want to become? At the age of 50, what is your plan? What is your goal? Today, next month, what is your aim? And what is your prioritization today? Which work is more important? Which work is more urgent? Have you prioritized it? And structure your time. Structuring is very, very important. So most of the time we have a prime time. Morning is called as a prime time. Afternoon it is slightly a dull time. So very important tasks, you try to finish it in the morning. The afternoon after, people used to tell, a half stomach will never receive ethics. If I tell Ramayana, Mahabharata, Gita to a hungry person, he will not listen. But in a full stomach, nothing will be listened. So that way, you have to structure your time based on the day. Then another important thing, always be focused. Observe. R.K. Lakshmanan was asked, R.K. Lakshmanan, you are drawing beautiful cartoons. What is the secret of it? R.K. Lakshmanan report that I am focused. I used to observe things. So we are all seeing, somebody is observing. That is the difference between most of us and the successful persons. Please always remember, be focused. In a school, when a school teacher asks the students, whatever I am doing, you try to do it. A student says, okay, sir. He took a sugar and put it on his mouth. Students repeated. And he touched the sugar and he touched the ice. All the students did the same. Next time, a chili powder, the teacher touched and took that finger, his eyes, and he touched the eyes and asked the students to do it. Students said, no, how can we do, sir? This is a chili powder. How you did it? Teacher again repeated. And all the students said, Sir, how it is magic, sir? Chilli powder also, you are touching it on to your eyes. How it is possible? Teacher said, I touched on my index finger chilies and I touched the middle finger on my eyes. You are seeing but not observing. There is a difference between seeing and observing. Remember, always be focused. And always everything, what next, what is to be done. For example, today's meeting, Priya madam has organized this meeting. So for her, she does spend a lot of time planning it. She did. That is why I am before you. So anything, a good organized, we call it as organization. So organized with the focused, with good structure, prioritizing, setting goals and planning ahead. That this is enough for the whole time management. Next. So remember, plan your future. Always Mark Twain used to tell, you repeatedly plan what I should be, because there you are going to spend rest of your life. People, most of the people, those who have missed their life, they fail in their life, they are not successful because of poor planning. In a country as a whole, why our country is not prospering? Why our drainage systems are not working? During rains, why our people, they all shout? The same people during summer, they ask for water because we are not planned. The country is not planned. That is the reason. In our country, our annual rainfall is 1100 millimeter. Same country like Israel, the annual rainfall is 400 millimeter. But they export costliest vegetables. How? Because of the good plan they make. For everything in a family, for a classroom, for your future, always remember, plan, plan, plan. That is the secret of success. Next. But we don't plan to fail. Our problem is we fail to plan. Next. So for this planning, the present, what you have to do is, Alan Lacan, the time management guru, used to tell that there is a, for goal attainment, you have to plan. How to plan? Next. Next. So first important thing is, from today onwards, please always keep your table, workplace, in your house. You keep the materials in the proper places. I used to tell, for everything there is a place and everything should be in its place. So this is not the way. Most of the office, you go, government offices, places, people used to put, when you ask a paper, they will search, search, search. They will invent, they will discover. Like Columbus discovered America. So they will invent, discover a particular paper. So repeatedly they will purchase pencils. The same house, hundreds of pencils are available. So many erasers are available. Repeatedly purchasing erasers, pen. So many materials. So all because of not keeping in its place. This will save a lot of time. My first presentation itself, I said 2 hours, 2 years, we are all losing for searching for the old items, the missed items. So keep always your desk clean. That is the message. Next. So a place for everything and everything in its place. Suppose the total electricity is failed in your house. Completely the house is dark. If I ask some material, if you are ready and slightly going and picking up the correct material, means your house, everybody is good. Somebody's house, if I ask them, can you get me the Tuesday Hindu paper? People, they search, 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 and they are unable to bring or unable to get the old newspaper. But Kannimara library, lakhs and lakhs of books were stored. You go to the librarian, quickly they are telling, go to the 8th floor, 3rd veranda, 8th rack, ground, you are getting the book. How? So when it is properly arranged, picking is easy. Correctly you can identify. You will not duplicate it. You will not waste it. Your time is saved. Everything. So look on the table, there is a pencil holder. Where if you keep everything? Your switch, your water bottle, the place, keep it clean. So that way you can save your time. Next. So always be simple. Find what works. Use it consistently and sort it by items. Next. Remember, very, very important point is diary writing. You may tell, sir, I am having laptop, I am having computer. You have all the modern gadgets. Remember, sometimes the grandfather technology is better than biotechnology and nanotechnology. This diary writing is a very good habit. 2021 is going to emerge shortly. At least those who missed these very important items so far, try to purchase a diary, because the reason is you can write, you can include so much think. You will not miss it. What is to be done? Addresses, important telephone numbers, important messages. You can plan. It is something. Keeping a diary means you are employing a personal assistant. Whenever you write it on a diary in the morning, definitely you will not forget. The reason is, when you started scribbling on a paper, naturally the message goes and touches the neurons of the brain. So many persons, Jawaharlal Nehru, Indira Gandhi, the former prime ministers, during that type of strains, hard work, they used to write diaries. They maintained diaries. So here in our system, you know, while I was working in a college, I got a diary. I presented to a professor who is very close to me. I presented. What happened was, after 2 weeks, the same diary, moving to several persons, reached again to me. It means everybody is interested to present a diary to others. Nobody is interested to write a diary. So this is the problem. Keep a diary and see the difference, at least the year 2021. Next. So simple grid sheet. Nowadays, lot of smaller stationery, smaller packet notebooks are there, giving times, then worksheets, table sheets. Try to scribble. Keep it a small material in your packet. So what is today's, what is the work to be done? Note it. Suppose in your family, if they are telling, purchase these materials, means if you record it everything, you will never miss it. All the items will come. So everything, you record it, write it. It will not take more time. Just 5 minutes of time. That saves a lot of time. So that is the idea. Please. Next. Another thing, this telephone. This telephone. So I don't want to tell youngsters, students are here. So you should use it. Is it a boon or a bane? You have to tell. And if it is really useful, it is something like a knife. Remember, telephone is something like a knife. It can be used for making a surgery, and it can be used for cutting a vegetable, but the same knife can be used for murdering also. So what for you are using is very, very important. Nobody is against communicating, but it should be precise. It should be focused. It should be time oriented. Do not waste it in the name of telephone. Too much of talk, dragged talk. So all those things, so these are all very, very important. How to speak in a telephone? There is a book in your library, addressing or speaking in a telephone is a book. There are a lot of tips are available. Very quickly how to communicate. So that is the skill. So telephone, is it a boon or your bane? It is in your hand. You are going to use it carefully, use it rationally, use it purposefully. Without any purpose, do not take the telephone. The university today morning also, counseling is going on. Last 1 week, what I am observing is number of students, their parents, without reading the admission brochure, they straight away go the final contact number telephone. They immediately take the telephone and they are calling. So for everything, they think that a telephone is the thing. They never read. They never read the brochure. So use it correctly, correct purpose. Please. So remember, suppose a very important method is, suppose you are going for a work, very important work, morning 7 to 8, daily if you are attending the yoga, you tell your friends, morning 7 to 8, do not call me. Or you just put it in silent mode, or switch it off. Your career, your life is more important. Doing the yoga and picking the phone is not correct. because you want to develop, you want to protect your health, you want to conserve your time, you want to grow. Don't be the priority of other man's work. Observe your work. But all these tips, what I am telling, looks like silly, but remember that helps. So this is very, very important. Next, another thing is procrastination, postponement. So majority of the failures in life, you ask, they will postpone. Why you are not doing? They will tell a reason, and they will postpone. Major problem is they will never get up early in the morning. That is the problem. Somebody who is getting up 5:30 or 5 o'clock, the particular person in the life, they will be fast. They will plan correctly. They will do the things correctly. They know the value, because that is the prime time, morning 5:30 to 7 o'clock, these 1.5 hours, there will not be any disturbance. Phone calls will be less. Distractions due to television is less. So do not postpone things. Do it immediately. So that should be the life message. Next, one of the very important quote, I'm very sorry, students or participants who may not be knowing Tamil, so I will translate it in English. Valluvar, the great person, 4 important evils he said. Somebody, if you wanted to miss their life, the major important evil, what he is telling is, the first evil is nedunir. It means postponement. Maravi, forget. Madi means laziness. Tuil means sleep. So remember, Saint Valluvar is telling, the person who is going to lose the entire life if he started doing these 4 points. One is the first important thing. Again, he has given number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4. Number 1 is this procrastination, nedunir, forgetting, maravi, madi, that laziness, tuil, a prolonged sleep, unwanted sleep, planning to sleep during Sundays. Sunday morning, people used to plan, afternoon we have to sleep. So not because of tiredness they are sleeping, they wanted to sleep. So this is the thing. Please, the message from Valluvar, take it seriously. Next, any good decision that will turn to a bad, if you are taking or you are postponing these things, a good decision will turn to a bad one if it is applied too late. So people in the Tamil Nadu, one important quote they used to tell, ilamayil kal. So what a great 2-word mantra. It means after that you cannot read, you cannot recollect. Your brain will not be vibrant. Your neurosecretory muscles will not be fast. It will not be reactive. If you are applying it late, after 40 or 45, if you wanted to study something, the decision is a late decision. You cannot implement it. Even a good decision will turn to a bad because of this procrastination, this postponement. Indecision is worse than wrong decisions. Next. And again, the reasons why people are postponing, why they are not doing it immediately. There are reasons. Some they used to tell, why you are not writing a book? Sir, I wanted to write a book because I have my idea. Only thing is, I have to collect everything. It's a perfection. They expect certain perfection. The road to perfection is always under construction. Nobody cannot be a perfect person. On the whole world, only 2 persons are perfect. One is not born, another one is dead. Except these 2 persons, whole of the globe, nobody is perfect. So 100% perfectionism, if you are started expecting and you are postponing, really, that is not at all a thing. Another thing, fear of failure. So if you do a business, it will fail. I used to ask our agriculture college students, can we do a fruit shop after agriculture degree? So students said, sir, we can start a fruit shop, but fruits will rot, sir. Failure. Immediately, a negative thought, a negative idea, that there is no confidence, there is no skill. A mechanical engineer after a BE degree is not skilled to connect a fan. Number of computer engineers, computer persons, they do not know the practical aspects of the computer operations. There are so many persons, they are all, that is why Dr. Balagurusami, in one of the conferences, said that we are producing engineering graduates but not engineers. We are producing medical graduates but not doctors. We are producing agricultural graduates but agriculturally not skilled persons. So that way the country goes. Everybody gets a degree, but there is no skill in it. Another thing is lack of proper priorities, lack of no direction, no goal. If you ask most of the students will put the blame, telling that my family is poor, my father is not educated, the school is I studied is Tamil medium, and I am from a village, and I am not guided properly. So again and again, without, they wanted to put the blame to others. No direction, no goal. Remember always, up to higher secondary, if you tell these reasons, I am poor, I am Tamil medium, I am from a remote area, nobody is guiding, the reasons are slightly accepted. But after higher secondary also, if you have started telling the same thing, you will be considered really as a fool. Then self-doubt, will I win? Will it possible for me? I am suffering due to, I cannot walk, my health is poor, no confidence. And another thing is avoiding the responsibility. Shiv Kera, in his book, You Can Win, kindly read who is winner and who is loser. The winners have a scheme, losers have a dream. The winner will say that I can do it. The loser will say that it is not my responsibility. So remember, avoiding the responsibility. Task distasteful. Nobody is ready to take the task. No sense of urgency. If you say that this is important, they will not sense it, and uncomfortable. So there is no involvement, there is no dedication, there is no devotion. So all these things put together, people to postpone things. So this is the reason. So there are still so much. These are all the major reasons. Most of us suffer due to these diseases. Next. How to break these postponements? How to break it? So arrange the priorities, focus it, set certain deadlines, avoid being perfect, always think a positive side. So always think positive. If you daily three negative things, if you think, the day is gone. Daily, if you pass some negative messages to your neighbor, that fellow is also gone. Move with the positive people. Please be positive. That will break the postponement of things. Next. So in order to live free and happily, you must have boredom. It is not always easy to sacrifice Richard Bach. Next. So remember, whenever you wanted to do a work, you need not do it immediately. This technique is called as elephant technique. You cannot take a jackfruit on a day, but the thorns, first outer coat, you remove it. You have to swallow a frog. Don't look at it too long. If you look at it too long, it may look like a big thing, but slowly, slowly, have a small bite. Start it. Slowly, if you do it, it will come. So if a jackfruit, outer portion, when you look the jackfruit, it may be big. Remove the outer core, inner seeds, unwanted items. Slowly, slowly, put it in a polythene bag. 2 to 3 polythene bags, the entire jackfruit will come. Daily, you can take few jackfruits. So when you look certain things, it may look like a big thing. But when you started doing it, the big will also comes to for a smaller bite. That's all. Next. Another important thing in creating the hardest part is to begin. You start. Well begun is half done. Just start it. Don't postpone it. Reward yourself. Daily you think, so I am the best person. I am a good person. I am confident. I have talents. I am skilled. Break it up. Smaller units. Buy the benefits. So whenever you postpone things, remember you are postponing the success. That is the message. Next. Another important thing, don't be late. In a class, in a seminar, in a symposium, or a meeting, anything, if 10 o'clock is fixed, enter into the hall 9:50, occupy the first row seats. have a book or a diary with you. Be prepared for yourself to listen. Hear. Hear the word. Inside there is a word called as ear. Your ear, E-A-R, is inside here. So always be in time. Don't tell the reasons. Don't tell the reasons. America, you cannot tell a reason that train is late, because the train will not be late there. In a country like India, you can tell, sir, I wanted to come, but meal grease, 1.5 hours late. That is why I am late. The reason, it is being quoted in most of the international conferences, that is called as Indian punctuality. Indians means they will always come in late. So keep, because these will boost your self-image, your self-esteem. If you are in time, you are, the office will recognize you, the class will recognize you, your teachers will recognize you. So always, please be in time. Next. So what I am telling is, telephone, who has invented telephone, everybody will tell that Alexander Graham Bell. It is accepted. But remember, two persons were trying for the invention of telephone. One is Alexander Graham Bell, another one is Antonia Meakey. But Antonia Meakey name was not at all found in science. He was 3 hours late to file the patent of the invention of telephone. Now, the entire world, people are using telephone. Alexander Graham Bell is recognized. A person who just for 3 hours time was not at all recognized. So that is life. Next. If I wanted to chop the tree, and the tree, to chopping the tree, if it requires 8 hours, sharpen the axe. So you can very quickly do the job. So a blunt axe, don't take. Like that, daily morning, sharpen your brain with newer thoughts, newer goals, newer ideas, newer positive habits. So thereby you can manage the time. Next. It is the efficiency or effectiveness. People, sir, I am efficient, don't tell. Hereafter, please be effective. Efficiency is doing the job right. Effectiveness is doing the right job. Doing the right job is correct. Not because you are doing something hard work, you are from morning 8 o'clock to 12 o'clock, you are doing something which is not at all productive. That is not the work. You may be efficient, but you hereafter, people should be effective. When you want to become effective, you should maintain time. Time management is the mantra. Next. So daily, to make a to-do list. The night, when you go to your bed, 5 minutes please spend. The governor of Pondicherry, Kiran Bedi, used to tell the students, daily you just write in a small scribbling pad, what I did it today. Today morning I got up. What are the things I did it? I learned this book, okay, 1 hour. I attended the class, 2 hours. I attended this conference, 2 hours. You repeatedly focus, then only you can analyze yourself where the time has gone, where the time has been wasted. So that self-auditing will help you to manage the time. Next. And use a spare time minutes wisely. You are going to a hospital, take a book along with you. Instead of waiting and chit-chatting to the neighbor, you can read the book. You are traveling in a train, you take a very important material along with you. Do it. Do the work. It is called as a two bats with one stone. You want to listen to music, do watering of your home garden and listen to the music. So that way, even the spare minutes, you can do it. There are a number of agriculture university students. One of my students called Irayan, who is IAS officer. What he used to do is, during the student days, he used to record the class notes. The bus and all, he listened. He listened to the class lectures. He used to record the audio and he listens. Will travel. That way, some people in a travel, all those things, using the minutes, every minute is very, very important. Next. What I am telling is, this Frederick Cahill, everybody will be knowing, he's the inventor of benzene. So I don't want to go in detail. This invention happened while he was sleeping. While he was sleeping, he had a dream. Look on the right corner top. A snake bites its tail. So in the dream, while repeatedly he is thinking, finally only he knowing the image, he made a structural formula C6H6. Today that is the world, that is organic chemistry. Then seen the invention came during sleep. So during sleep also, people, they were thinking, they are spending their time for productive purpose. So that's the message. Next, Archimedes, while he is taking bath, so everybody, we also daily take bath. Archimedes, while he is dipping in a well in his head, he found out the principle called as Archimedes principle. A body immersed in a fluid is buoyed up by a force equal to the weight of the displaced fluid. Still, in science, a very important principle. This invention came. This important write-up came. This in bath also, people, they have time to do science. Next. Similarly, Isaac Newton. Isaac Newton, while he is sleeping, an apple fell on his head. That made him to develop Isaac Newton's gravitational law. The third law. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. It has just because, so during the damn sleep, so apple when it falls, so there also it plays the time. There came invention. Next, another important thing, do not say okay to say no. Don't say yes when you intend to say no. As I said, say no to disturbance. While you are reading in your room, close the room. The roommate or the other person who are disturbed, you tell them, do not disturb me. This is my prime time. I am reading. I am writing. Don't disturb me. I am for the development. Don't distract me. That way you have to speak. So friendship is important. But without our development, that friendship is not required. So that's the message. Next. Find the right time. So everybody, so what time is the best time? You think. Some what they will do is, the night 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, they will do certain work, computer work and all. So such a time when you started doing against the biological clock, what will happen is the immunity power of the body will go down. We have a biological clock. So that biological clock is functioning based on the climatological niches existing on the outside. So do not break it. Try to go along with the biological clock and do your time. And for that, find always the right time. Next. Get a very good sleep. When the sleep is distracted, the biological clock is broken, the next day, the whole day will be over, wasted. You remember the biological clock, the yoga they are telling is, suppose you have crossed after 12 o'clock, and if you go to a bed, 12:05, the sleep will not come. The biological clock, you'll get the sleep only at 2:30. If you are missing the 2:30, again the sleep will come after 4 o'clock. So knowing all these things, physiological parameters of the body, in the morning, that helps for a good time management principle. Next. And smaller tips. Smaller tips. These are tips just, these are tips of a tip of an iceberg. There are so much. How many of you having a railway timetable? How many are having the telephone index? How many of you have in your house, you are having a pin code book? A visiting card holder. So many visiting cards you have received. Is it has been arranged in a proper way? How many of you attending this, this seminar or having the skill for typewriting? Do you mean to say learning the typewriting A to Z without looking the keyboard? Is it a very costliest input? Calculator operations. Then making a small post office around you. Some stamps, some covers. Smaller materials, some revenue stamps. All these helps. In a, some people, even in a purse, they will make a post office. Whatever you ask, they will give you. Lower denominations. Somebody in your house, they will come. 5 rupees, 10 rupees. While you are traveling, you may require 1 rupee coin. While you are traveling in a scooter for air check, you may require 5 rupee coin. So smaller denominations, that saves time. A small table toolbox, a dictionary, you arrange, keep everything in your house, look the next day, so much of time can be saved. So this is only this list is only a smaller thing. I have too much, so many is available. This is only an idea. You develop accordingly and save the time. Next, and use your time wisely in the sense. So we are a watch, reality, routine, what is to be done, peak time, where to go. When I go in the afternoon to 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock, the grocery shop, there will not be less crowd, so my time will be saved that way. When to do this work, where to go, which time you have to go. When you wanted to go to a person to meet, you have a phone call, get his appointment, don't waste your time. So use all your time very, very wisely. That's the message. Next. Remember a famous quote called as, a stitch in time, save 9. Suppose there is a smaller a door near to a button. If I just put a stitch, immediately it is ready. But if I leave it, what will happen? The entire shirt is gone. So timely action, a stitch in time, save 9. So for that, the clock from morning, what is first, what is second, what is due, where to go, when to go, for these things, phone, bath, everything. Next. So next important point is, so this is a matrix. In life, first quarter is important and urgent. If it is important and urgent, you give the top priority. A examination, a crisis, a deadline, a project, a meeting, a very important preparation. That area you focus first. That is highly important place. Second quarter is important, but not urgent. Relationship, recreation, some preparation. So these are all maybe important, but not urgent. You keep it low. Third quarter, it is maybe urgent, but it is not important. So you wait third quarter. It may be an interruption, a phone call which is not attended now, some mail. You need not check the mail every 1 hour. So that is not very important. Maybe urgent. Then the last quarter, it is not urgent and not important. Cinema, junk mail, escapism. So all those things. Some people, to send a friend to a railway station, 15 persons will be accompanying him, disturbing to the general public, and they waste their time. And not urgent, not important in life, they give 80% importance. Important and urgent, that they give 20% important. The Pareto's rule applies. So this is a chart. So this will give an idea where to focus important and urgent. Next. So for important and urgent, do it now. Next. So important and not urgent, decide when to do it. Not important and urgent. Next. Delegate it. Not important and not urgent, dump it. Next. So what is the prime time? So Tamil it is called as Brahma Murtham. So very important time. So before 10 a.m. So the solitude, the concentration, your creative thinking, all are very, very fine. Your brain will absorb more. So that time you do the work. You most important items, you spend it in a prime time. The early bird usually catches the worm. So create your ideas. Do it in the early morning. So this is the message. Next. My question is, everybody is having 12 months. Can this 12 months be made into 13 months? Is it possible? My students replied, sir, it is not at all possible. How can I? Only 12 months are available. It is God given. How can I made it to 13 months? Answer is, yes, it is possible. You get up 1 hour early in the morning. From today onwards, you will be getting 13 months. Napoleon is an early riser. hours less sleep per day. That is the, he said, 5 years your working life will be increased. Next. Jawaharlal Nehru, in his office, he used to keep a message on his table, the famous quote, Robert Frost, Dr. J. Jayalalitha, former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, number of the meetings and assemblies, he used to quote this Robert Frost famous quote, woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep. And miles to go before I sleep. So the message is, my travel is very long. I have to go a lot of work. I have to do a lot of work. I have a lot of dreams. I have a lot of aim. I have a lot of goals. So that way my life has to go up. Remember these beautiful words always. Next. Kennedy, the American president, used to tell, don't ask what the country did for you. Instead, ask what you did for the country. And always in his office, he used to tell, so people, do not spend more time with me. When he entered in my office as the president, you must leave this office within 5 minutes. So because time is most important for him. So Kennedy is a very right person, a role model for time management. Next. Similarly, Tamil Nadu, Rajagopal Acharya, Rajaji, the former chief minister of Tamil Nadu, used to tell, you ask anything, I will give you, but don't ask my time. Next. So I don't want to go with the details of this song written by Mahakavi Bharathiyar. Most of us, our life, so daily we get up, we take some food, Kedithinam Sorithindru, some stories we make. Then we hurt other person, Vadi Thinbam Miga Ulandru, Pirar Vada. So many persons, bad things we will do. Then you get gray hairs. Then slowly we get some disease and we will die. Like these ordinary persons, I will not die. My life is totally a different one. For that, Bharathiyar wrote this beautiful song. This, we have to keep it in our heart also. Next. So the famous person, Swami Vivekananda, said, arise, awake and stop not. Please note this word, stop not till the goal is reached. So a great sign, the famous word also indirectly give more importance for time. Because he said, arise. Arise means it's timely. That is the message. Next. Now I will ask the question. I am coming to the end because my time limit is another 10 minutes. We asked this question, Stephen Covey's book. I got these photographs and I made this slide. If I ask whether this jar is full, people will tell, okay, sir, jar is full because you filled the jar with stones. No, jar is not full. Next. You can add certain sand. If I add sand and if I ask whether the jar is full, you will tell, okay, sir, jar is, first you have put a lot of small stones. Now you have added soil. So jar is full. No, still jar is not full. Next, you can still add fine sand and make a small jerk. The fine sand will go down. If I ask, now the jar is full, you will tell, yes, jar is full, sir. First stone, then sand, then fine sand. What else? No, still it is not full. Next, you can add water. So what the message I am going to tell is, you will tell, I don't have time. No, you have time. You have time for exercise. You have time to develop your skill. You have time to read. You have time for your development. All is inside you. You have to use it. But what is very important from the story of the message is, next, what is to be put first? If you keep water first, and adding big stones, that cannot be filled. So what first, what second, and what third, and what fourth? That way you have to fill it up. That is the message. Put the big rocks in first. Next. So that way you have to fill it. Please remember, don't spend more of your time for speech, chatting, unwanted items. Speech is silver. Silence is gold. One of the Pondicherry Ashramam. I got this write-up. Pondicherry Ashramam, beautiful write-up was mentioned. Adhikam pesadavanai ulagam virumbugiradhu, alandhu pesuvavanai ulagam madikkiradhu, pesadha gnaniyai ulagam thodugiradhu, pesiya vaarthaikku adhu yajaman, pesadha vaarthaikku nee yajaman. Try to reduce the talk. So, show it in your action. Next. Yesterday is a waste paper. Today is a newspaper. Tomorrow is a test paper. So, that is why we call it as present time. Present tense. So, today, look back. Don't look back. Throw it. It's a waste. But today is very important. Tomorrow is still more important. What can I do after this 3:30? What I can plan for tomorrow? March, as said by Robert Frost, miles to go before I sleep. And miles to go before I sleep. Next. And though I said I am going to come to an end, and you will all now listen, and you will all finally tell, no sir, whatever you tell in life, everything is luck, sir. It is not hard work, or it is not time management, or it is not anger management, or it is not water management, no management. It is luck, sir. If you are luck, you will get everything. So remember, this luck is having a deeper meaning. Luck is only an abbreviation. The expansion of luck is next. Labor under correct knowledge. Use your knowledge. Do your labor within you, within your heart. Use it correctly and you will get luck. That's all. Next. You are not useless, but you are all useless. So with this, so another a beautiful quote in Tamil. Sindhikka nerathai chelaviduvom, vilayada nerathai chelaviduvom. So when you play, you will be youth. When you smile, your atma will be beautiful. When you work, you will be successful. When you love, it is the blessings of the God. When you have friendship, you will be more happy. When you give others, the joy will be doubled. When you are going for certain things and helping others, compassion comes. So there where you will reach and touch the blessings of the God. So it all happens when you started doing from youth or play or smile or work or love or friendship, everything. Use this time wisely. Next. So today's world, time, everybody, even in a toilet, even in a restroom. So you should have computer, you should have phone. There also, you have to work. Though I may be boring and I may be some overreacting, or you may all curse me, but remember, this is what the world goes. Nowadays, you have to work like this. Time management experts say, even in the toilet, people have to read newspaper, you have to operate a computer, you have to communicate. And tomorrow, next few years, next, you have to sit on the toilet and do it. So everything will be around you, even in the toilet. There, it may be a joke, but take it very seriously. That way the world goes. I asked my students, in a year, in a day, 24 hours are there. Okay. 24 hours, you have to do 48 hours of work. Students said, how can I do, sir? Only 24 hours are available. How can I work for 48 hours? Remember, every 2 hour work, you have to do it 1 hour, within 1 hour. That way you have to improve the skill. That is tomorrow. Tomorrow will be like that. So that way time has to be managed. Next. Change. So the end. So you'll all now dream, okay, tomorrow we have to change. So change is in everybody's mouth, but only when few people practice. That few people are successful people. The great end of life is not knowledge, not recording, not writing, but action. It is not words, it is deeds. That helps you. Next. So be the funny. Just keep going. Next. So with this, I do not know from 2.5 hours. So my time limit was 3:25, 3:30. They gave the time. Before 5 minutes, I finished my talk. The message is: do the time wisely, and be purposeful. Be happy. So time and tide never waits for anybody. So you cannot purchase 1 inch of time by giving 1 inch of gold. Do not be the priority of another man's work. Sometimes we should be selfish also. So it doesn't mean I am asking all the entire participants be selfish. No, sometimes, because we have to grow, we have to read, we have to sharpen the knowledge. We should be more active. We should be skilled for that. Time management is the most important management. Thereby, the internal personality will be more. With this, I wholeheartedly thank for sparing your valuable time for this 1.5 hours. And I thank the organizers, especially Professor A. Priya, who called me a number of times and gave this opportunity to share what he touched my mind. Thank you very much. Thanks you once all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir, for the very wonderful session. Anita, ma'am? End of the session, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So thank you so much for the wonderful eye-opening session on time management. As your instructor, we will follow all the tips you have given for managing our time in a very useful way. Thank you really. Thank you so much for the wonderful session, sir. Really impressed for the session. Thank you so much, sir. And also, I thank all the participants for attending such an useful session. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for spending your valuable time. Anita, ma'am, you can stop the recording.
Okay, ma'am.